Forest Knolls Wellness. They're going to go ahead and do that 10-minute presentation. And we're going to open it up to questions from the advisory committee. And then we'll transition into the public comments. We will have that transition opportunity. We'll try to work in between doing the walking up to this mic and also passing this mic around for those that either cannot stand up or stand in line for the mic. We'll also do a quick poll to see how many people will be speaking, and we'll adjust the time for speaking at that moment. So if I can go ahead and have Forest Knolls come on up. Good evening. My name is Natalia Thurston, and I'm the attorney for Forest Knolls Wellness, the applicant for 6700 Sir Francis Drake Boulevard. I'd first like to take this opportunity to thank the County of Marin for adopting this ordinance and for taking the time to carefully craft a regulatory and licensing system for dispensaries. I'd also like to thank the Board of Directors of Forest Knolls Wellness, the property owner of the proposed site, and also the community for coming out. Regardless of whether you're for or against the issue, it's important that everybody's voice be heard in this regard. I would also like to take a brief moment to introduce myself. I was raised in San Francisco, and I went to the School of the Arts there and moved to Oakland a few years ago. I grew up as a direct witness to the benefits of medical cannabis. There was an AIDS hospice above my flat where I grew up on Dolores Street, and I saw the benefits of medical cannabis on AIDS patients and the relief that was provided to them through use of cannabis. And also, I used to wait for the bus in junior high right below the first Cannabis Buyers Club on Church and Market, where I witnessed patients safely able to obtain their medicine to treat their illnesses without any crime or problems associated with it as a child. And it is for this reason that I stand here before you in support of Forest Knolls Wellness's application. Next slide. So Forest Knolls Wellness is organized as a nonprofit. We intend to provide safe and local access to medicine. We will be using a state-of-the-art security system, strict protocol, restricting patients over the age of 18, and we intend to source medicine from the highest quality sustainable and organic cultivators in Northern California. We also intend to operate a community benefits program, including a once-a-week van shuttle service that will distribute cannabis to patients who qualify for the program, which will be open to disabled, handicapped, and low-income people. Our values are to provide a balance between the interests of the community in protecting their safety, health, and welfare, their children, and also providing safe access to patients who need it to obtain their medical cannabis locally. Our goal is to provide medicine in a safe environment with the least amount of impact. And we recognize there's an intention between the origins of the plant and the need to carefully craft regulations that protect the community and the environment. At this time, next slide please, I'd like to introduce our team. Our team is distinguished by a diverse group of Marin residents and longtime barrier residents, including seasoned professionals who have specific expertise in the area of nonprofit business management and law. The first person I'd like to introduce is Linda Dallaire, one of the Forest Knolls Wells directors and community liaison. I came to be part of this team because of my history with green building through industrial hemp. And I came to learn that hemp and cannabis sativa are the same plant. It's just that hemp has 0.3% THC. But the stalks of the plant, you can build a house from the stalk of the cannabis plant. And hemp has been, and cannabis have been with us for thousands of years, and it's been used as medicine in the 1500s, 1700s. It was used to treat your horses, to treat each other. Buddha, Jesus wore hemp robes. It's a plant that's been with us, and it's been vilified, and we can look at it in a different way. I look at hemp as medicine for the earth, and I look at cannabis as medicine for the people. I wouldn't be part of this team if I didn't stand up to that for me. So thank you. The next person I'd like to introduce is Kip Baldwin. He's director, and he will be responsible for the day-to-day management of the dispensary.
Good evening. To echo what Natalia started off, whether you're in support or opposition, I agree you all with love tonight. I've worked outside of what I've done in film and television. I've worked in local and sustainable agriculture. I've worked in local and sustainable business before I was doing this. My mission in life, my every waking hour is devoted to finding solutions. I probably, like a lot of you in this room, 10 years ago, before I did the show Weekend, but I was not an advocate. A friend of mine who had Lyme disease made me his caretaker. I went into a dispensary in Berkeley, and I was, wow, this has changed since high school. And so I wanted to educate myself more. And what I found out blew my mind. To echo much of what Linda said, it was a remarkable plan. I devoted then time to focusing energies on senior use, where there's seniors now getting almost complete remission from Alzheimer's. I supply parents with who have autistic children with cannabis when they can't get any of the relief. Our show Weekend, we focused on the Stanford doctor whose son had childhood epilepsy, and this was the only relief that they could get without literally life-threatening medical procedures. They went from 12 seizures a day to one a week. I understand the concerns people have, but I really encourage you to educate yourselves. After Weekend, which I like to look at as the will and grace of the cannabis movement, about a year after that, Sanjay Gupta came out with and said, listen, we've been duped. For 70 years, we've been lied to about this plan. Again, I respect your concerns, but I ask you to do what I did and educate yourself. And again, thank you for your time.
The next person I'd like to introduce is Brian Hilliard. He's also a director of Forest Knolls Wellness. And as an attorney, he's in charge of our regulatory compliance.
One thing I forgot to mention, I've been in the Bay Area since 85. 15 of those years has been as a Marin resident. 10 in Sausalito and now in Santa Fe. I live here in Marin. I care about Marin. I love Marin. I love what Marin has always stood for. Marin has always been at the forefront, leading the edge of conscious shifting movements. So.
Good evening. My name is Brian Hilliard. As the bio says, I am an attorney. I represent cannabis clubs, delivery services. I sit on this board because I know the advisory role when it comes to law and these programs. I advise investors, I advise dispensary and growers with how to structure their businesses so that they're within regulation policy. But the reason I'm with this group, the reason I'm here talking to you, is because, and I'll tout my Marin connection, I taught the Branson schools, that really does a thing there, connection. But I believe in this community. This is a community that needs a thoughtful group of directors like this. From a legal perspective, they follow every single rule and regulation. A lot of people come and talk to me, and they say, Brian, how can I open my dispensary? How do I do a grow in my garage? How do I do these things? And I walk them through the problems of doing each and every single one of these cannabis businesses. But one thing about this company, this group, is that they not only care about the community, but they're following every single regulation out there to make sure that this dispensary is right in this community legally and at the advice of the board. So thank you for listening, and thank you for hearing.
You can skip that one. Next I'd like to introduce Rebecca LaFour. She's one of the property owners at 6700. You can leave it on that slide, thank you. She has been instrumental in providing us with valuable information about the property regarding traffic and parking based on her family's ownership of the property for 70 years and the property's prior use by her late father as a gas and garage station for 49 years. She's also here to answer any specific questions about the property, if there are some by the panel.
Hi, you can call me Becky. My parents were Don and Myra Urian, and my brothers and I were born and raised in Forest Knolls. And though we left in 74 to move to Pen Grove, we actually really never left. Our heart's always been here, and we all were still connected with the family that was here. Besides operating the properties of the Forest Knolls Trailer Court at 6700 Sir Francis Drake Boulevard, my career path ranges from the love of trees that was born on the trails of Samuel P. Taylor Park to forestry, park ranger of Lake Sonoma with the Army Corps of Engineers and with park manager Steve Phelps, law enforcement in Marin County, special ed via Matrix in Nevada with Jeannie Bowman, and my dairy life, where my husband and I have been together for 33 years, where we have two adult children and have sponsored close to 60 foreign exchange students from agricultural universities from 20 countries. I'm obviously in favor of this small, intimate dispensary getting the permit because it is a golden opportunity for all involved. I would like to personally invite all of you on the panel and decision makers in the process to come to the property for a private tour where you can have a hands-on experience and see for yourselves how perfect the site and this group of people really are. You, the panel, may not be able to do this with many or any of the other applicants who are having new builds or are working with structures that have that are going to be have like a year's worth of improvements or longer. I would like to empathize to the community that yes, it's scary dealing with the unknown and replacing previous ideas with new knowledge. The only people that really come out to the valley are the ones who live out here and the ones passing through to other destinations. How wonderful it could be to provide access to locals and travelers spending their money in Marin County to get access to their medication and other sundries all in one place. A place made up of individuals providing goods from local suppliers and not corporations. I feel this group, the Forest Knolls Wellness Group, is humanitarian and health-oriented with strong values. They are primary producers in business and for community-based projects that fill the voids of health and welfare in their own communities. I know the Forest Knolls Wellness Group getting the permit will be a lease situation where my brothers and I are the landlords. By effect, we are supplemental support for the businesses in place to remain compliant to all regulatory agencies through the guidelines of our leases. The dispensary is not a standalone. It really is a stand together effort. Our property is the perfect location for the Marin County's first dispensary in its unincorporated area because our family has owned the property for the past 70 years, where we have had to be a continuous partner for sustainability, providing local resources to all of its members and tourists passing through. Since our parents' passing in 2005 and then 2009, my brothers and I have been very civic-minded in our operations of 6700 Sir Francis Drake, where we have provided the community with a nexus for small business and local sustainability. Our property is small by design, but it is huge in what it has offered in the past, and with your help, can sustain for the future. It is not going to be a roadside circus show, as proven by its past history. And it won't mushroom into a huge venue for weddings or crazy recreational tourism. It can't. It's too small. Plus, that is not the vision of any of its tenants currently operating from there. The tenants that my brothers and I have chosen over others. The property is self-correcting, a small lot, but has ample space to increase for parking and access to other entrances and unrealized rental income or donated space for other nonprofit support groups and meetings. Thank you so much for your time today. Next slide, please. I'd like to introduce Megan Walsh. She's a project attorney who's worked on the application with me, who has expertise in land use and environmental issues, and also David Chapman. He's a local Marin attorney with real estate and civil litigation expertise, who's also serving as one of the project's legal advisors and community liaisons. Next slide, please. Now I'm going to dive into the actual site plan and the details of the project. In the interest of time, I'm going to try to keep this moving pretty quickly. This is the site, the proposed site at 6700 Sir Francis Drake. It's currently zoned for VCR Village Commercial Residential. The property also complies with the San Geronimo Valley Community Plan as it's designated as neighborhood commercial mixed use. This is one of the sites that was selected by the county after an extensive zoning and environmental review process as suitable for use as a medical cannabis in a dispensary. In fact, the buildings are currently used as commercial properties, so they already support that type of use. The building A is currently occupied by the farm stand, and building B is currently has two existing businesses, garage land and pump espresso bar. Both the owner and myself have communicated with the existing tenants that we hope to be able to relocate the farm stand into building B so as not to displace any business. And Jim Baum, the owner of the farm stand, I have been in direct communication with him, and he seems amenable to that plan and is open to working with us to accomplish that. So there will be a limited amount of construction, a minimal build out for this site. Next slide, please. The architectural drawing is the site plan. This is small, but you can see that in our drawings, they comply with all of the security requirements of Ordinance 3639, including secure doorways, a security guard at the front, proper lighting. The interior will have a minimal build out. It will be open, light, airy, similar to the clinical model that was presented by the county earlier. There will be no bars or windows or neon signs on the dispensary. And the build out, the exterior modifications will also be minimal, and the build out will be focused just on making sure that it complies with the requirements of Ordinance 3639. Next slide, please. The Forest Knolls Wellness is organized as a nonprofit mutual benefit as required for distribution of medical cannabis under state laws. There is some confusion among many people, and I get this question a lot, as to whether a nonprofit can earn a profit and what is done with those profits. So I'd like to just briefly delve into how we're structured financially. The profits of the dispensary will be retained within the dispensary. They will, under California law, a nonprofit may not distribute profits to individual shareholders. So there are no individual shareholders of Forest Knolls Wellness. The officers and employees are paid salaries in accordance with reasonable market rates in the surrounding community. Any excess profits are used to improve the business, whether it's through capital improvements, going back into our extensive community benefits programs, providing more benefits for the employees that work there. So all of the profits will be retained within the business, and none of them will be distributed to individuals. A lot of people don't know this, but Kaiser Permanente is a nonprofit, and that's an example of a business, a very large enterprise that earns money and earns revenue, but those revenues are retained within the company, and that's how we plan on operating Forest Knolls Wellness as well.
We have financed this project through a series of individual loans. Under California law, the only legal way a nonprofit can raise money is through interest-bearing loans, and that's what we've done in this case. Once the loan is issued, Forest Knolls Wellness Directors will maintain financial controls and financial transparency on an ongoing basis by hiring the Hank Levy Group, which is an accounting firm that specializes in California medical cannabis industry and has familiarity with industry-specific issues such as Section 280E. Next slide, please. Community benefits. The directors have envisioned Forest Knolls Wellness as an alternative healing center that integrates with the existing businesses. The directors are the kind of people that give back to the community, and they seek to return benefit to the community. I believe it was the intent of the ordinance to permit Marin residents who seek an active role in the management and day-to-day operations of the facility, which is what Forest Knolls Wellness intends to do. We have a strong community benefits program in place for veterans, reduced pricing, low-income patients, and local hiring practices, which is all set forth in our application. Next slide, please. Environmental benefits. There are a lot of environmental benefits to having a brick and mortar dispensary. As one grower mentioned, local patients can gain access to organic, clean, lab-tested medicine to remove the likelihood of tainted medicine. Forest Knolls Wellness will also be employing the track and trace system and lab testing requirements imposed by the new regulations under MCRSA, and will also prevent the black market sale of cannabis illegally grown with toxic pesticides. It will also reduce the carbon footprint of patients traveling to other counties to obtain medicine, such as San Francisco, or using unlicensed, unregulated delivery service. Forest Knolls Wellness also plans to source medicine from licensed cultivators who use sustainable farming methods such as water conservation techniques and the elimination of toxic pesticides in water runoff. Next slide, please. Just to briefly talk about the impacts on the health, wealth, and safety of the community, we plan to reduce crime by having a state-of-the-art security system. All medicine and product will be locked in safes, and there will be, on a nightly basis, there will be strict employee protocols in place for cash handling that are employed by other dispensaries in the state. We'll use an electronic POS system, cashless ATM, so there should be a limited amount of cash on hand. There are also rules of membership so that if someone is caught loitering or smoking consumption in the parking lot, they will be expelled from the dispensary. The last comment I would like to make is that there have been some concerns about children passing in front of the farm stand at the potential site for the dispensary. One of the community members who attended the meet and greet suggested possibly moving the entrance of the dispensary to the rear of Building B and also the parking, so that way children passing in front of the dispensary would not be an issue because the entrance to the dispensary would be in the back, and the parking for the dispensary would also be moved to the back area, thereby making it more safe. So if this is considered as a condition of the permit, the directors would be open to making changes to the plans to accommodate that. Lastly, I'd just like to thank the advisory board for your consideration of our application, and also I wanted to turn in to the county our petition from change.org with 619 signatories on it supporting the application. Thank you.
I was going through the application, I was having trouble seeing hands-on experience running a dispensary. Can you talk about who actually has experience in that arena, or if they don't, how you plan on filling that gap?
Well, Kip Baldwin has experience in retail food and beverage, which is quite similar to running a dispensary in certain fashion. Well, it is. It's a retail business that's open to the public and sells a product. Whether you want to agree with me or not, that's fine. But he has the management skills along with the rest of the team. I have expertise in regulations, employee handbooks, operation, as do some of the other attorneys on the team. We have so many attorneys on the team because it is a highly regulated industry that's rapidly changing, so we want to make sure that we advise the management of those changes as readily as possible.
And I have one other question. In the application it says, Forest Knolls will obtain medical cannabis for distribution only through a closed circuit of collective vendors. And I didn't know what that, can you explain what that means?
Sure. So under California law, as it exists now, you have to operate as a nonprofit mutual benefit corporation, which is also known as a collective. So what that means is that anybody that you're transacting with has to be a patient member of your collective. So that's a closed loop. You can't transact with anyone that's not a qualified patient.
So you're not referring to where you're getting the product?
Yes, even receiving the product and purchasing the product has to be done within a closed loop circuit from other patients.
Okay, thank you.
Part of our role as the advisory committee is to listen to the community concerns and address them with you in this public hearing. And I heard during the presentation that, you know, your group looks for solutions, and it seems to me, looking around at the number of no's in this room, no hats, no signs, no stickers,
no way.
That the community, the community has a serious concern with your dispensary, and where's Matt Shotwell? I mean, what, that's his word.
A potential buyer of the property. As you know, the property is up for sale and the current owners wish to sell the property and he's an interested buyer, so I don't know where he is.
And that seems to be, I mean, reading through the community's comments and what's been forwarded to us from the community in which you plan to be a member of, I really didn't hear anything in your presentation about how you plan on bridging this gap with the community. And they've raised significant concerns with your dispensary, and we've had, and this is not just an issue with your dispensary, a generic, you know, we're gonna be green, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do that, but, you know, not a really a singular statement addressing the very, very legitimate concerns of this community. So I wonder, well, how are you gonna, if you got the license, bridge that gap?
Well, we did hold a meet and greet in October to find out what some of the community concerns were, which we identified as four primary concerns: the parking, traffic, safety, and crime. So we have been in contact with community members attempting to mitigate some of these concerns, including suggesting that because there are children that pass in front of 6700 Sir Francis Drake, that we move the entrance of the dispensary and the parking to the rear to address and mitigate that community concern. I believe, and it's my opinion, that many people who are in favor of the dispensary are afraid to vocalize their support, and they've addressed it.
Do you respect
personally emailed me and told me that because of federal prohibition or because of their employment or because of their children or for whatever reason, for privacy issues, they prefer not to stand in public in their support, yet they have privately supported, they have emailed the county, and they have supported our project. So in my opinion, their voice is not properly being heard because of federal prohibition and the fears that still surround the plant.
How many of the 619 signatures on the change.org petition, which you just handed to the county, are residents of this direct community?
I don't have an exact number. I have to look at the petition myself. There's a few in here. It's printed on the materials.
I have a few questions. One is, can you hear me?
Yes.
Do you guys have plans in terms of, you can plan for all eventualities, but there was some concern expressed at our last meeting regarding the government changing the federal's, you know, changing their outlook with regard to state programs, and I wondered if you guys had any interim plans.
Interim plans?
Not interim, but...
Well, our intent is
contingency.
Well, our intent is to comply with the changes to state law. So we do intend to apply for a state medical license when the time comes in 2018. And obviously we're not gonna apply for a recreational license because the county just banned recreational sales. So our intent is to stay medical and then apply for a medical license in 2018 from the state.
Okay, and I also had a question of Kip Baldwin. I read your statement in the application, and I didn't understand when you talked about the love movement. You said the Just Love movement is about no longer making the choice to have our experience of life and love as one of being perpetually afraid, and so on.
Sure. I'm not sure what the question is. Yes, I believe that we've lived in a state of institutionalized fear for thousands of years with repetitive results that have been quite destructive to humanity. And I suggest that maybe coming from a place of love and understanding might be a better way to be. We can also look at the work I'm doing through an organization called Now Share Love. Again, my every waking moment is devoted to trying to make the world a better place. And anyone who wants to research me as much as you want, please do.
So, I think we're. I don't have any more questions.
Reading through your operations plan and the security plan, I think it's a great security plan.
Thank you.
I am concerned, however, about the wages you plan on paying your employees. I think you listed somewhere in the neighborhood of $11 an hour, and I know you talked about providing some medical benefits, but the complexity of the security and the complexity of the delivery process doesn't seem to bode well for somebody that you're going to pay for $11 an hour.
Actually, we're planning to start wage at $15 an hour. I just checked in the plan before I got up here. It says minimum wage is, I believe, $11.75 in Marin County, and we start.
That's what's listed in your operations plan.
Right, but we plan to start out at $15 an hour. I believe the plan says that minimum wage in Marin County is $11.75, but we plan to start the employees at $15 an hour with benefits. But if it appears that that's not a high enough wage to attract the type of person that we need that's qualified, then we'll of course consider raising the salary.
Okay, thank you.
I just wanted to make one last comment to really the audience, and that is we've heard now six of these applications. Now, we haven't heard from all the folks in the room yet, but I will say I've not heard of any location that people are for. And so I'm assuming that the county does want a medical dispensary at some point, the county and, or at least us and the board or the county administrator are going to have to make a difficult decision and balance what the community needs are and what the needs of the the patients that need this medicine are. So thank you for everyone's respect and keeping the applause at a minimum.
Thank you.